We're still chilling in these best of threes.
This is Losers Top 16, yeah. So we definitely have. All right, so whoever makes it into Losers, whoever wins this makes it into Top 12, then Losers Top 8. So we're getting things started off with with Mudace getting a pretty good percent right now.
Yeah, Mudace, Mudace's fundamentals are great, and especially like when you take a character like Peach, who's really good at whiff punishing, and then you try to apply that to a character like Lucina, it works really, really well.
And just look at that spacing right now. I want you to pay attention at the pressure that Mudace is putting on Daybreak. He's not letting him close in on him whatsoever. He's not letting him get this Nair loop started. He's really, really just spacing him out. And as I say that, he gets onto the ledge.
Yeah, and he's okay going to the ledge. The important thing is that you don't get hit by a combo starter move. Like, you're more than happy to go into disadvantage, go to the ledge, as long as you're not taking it that much percent from nairs, up airs, all that.
Yeah, no, I like that. Actually just turning around just to wait for the next option and punishing that one. And that's actually a huge thing that you'll notice about, like higher level players, that they're going to punish, they're going to punish the next move that comes
Exactly. Instead
of the one that you just did.
Yeah. Especially when you use moves that are so safe on shield like Lucina has. So good stuff to Daybreak punishing that. And hey, Daybreak, quick stock lead. The Palu Ditto now, though. Mudace kind of struggling to get something going. Like, he got Daybreak, that quick percent. Since then, hasn't really been able to get anything going. You cannot punish F-Smash with F-Smash like that.
Yeah, no, and the thing about Smash, it is all about stocks. It does not matter what percent your opponent's at. You can't see the stock. It's just not going to matter.
There's a good back throw, good stage position.
You always see Palutena throw out that explosive flame to try and bait out an option. Great jump in there to catch that.
Yeah, once Daybreak had committed low and attempted to air dodge the explosive flame, right? That was just Mudace's go ahead to, this is a free edge charge for me. I go take that nair.
Okay, now we have Wolf versus Palutena. This is something that's, you see this matchup in New York very often.
Oh, yeah?
And it always goes in Palutena's favor. Then again, it's because the Palutenas in New York are pretty it's disgusting.
Yeah, you guys have like four Palutenas.
This is Palutena and Wolf Jungle right here. Okay. Oh, I like that. Unfortunately, not connected with the back air.
And Mudace happy to circle camp right now. Just make sure that this Wolf doesn't get anything started.
And I mean, the thing about Wolf is that he has so many kill confirms. And the thing is that right now at 148, he kind of has to look for a raw smash attack or a back air, just like that. He doesn't really have any kill confirms to get that stock at the moment. But up tilt is going to do it with the whiff.
Yeah, Mudace just overcommitted just a little bit too much with that dash attack on the platform. Would have maybe liked to see like a drop down nair or something like that.
Oh my.
Then you continue the pressure, right?
Taking his turn up, throwing it against him, and Mudace, this is Peach right here. This is his tried and true. If he can't take out this Wolf, what is that going to say for the next match?
Yeah, and that's the thing, right?
Yeah.
Ooh, okay, well, he's taking it out, that's for sure. But it's always a struggle when your main can't beat somebody else's secondary in squad strike. That's mentally demoralizing in
so
many ways.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Because then you get tilted. Then you start, committing to unsafe options.
Yeah.
And you're like, why? Why? Okay, but I like his option to leave Roy for last. Roy has a lot of kill power, definitely has a lot of speed, and can definitely just clutch something out when you need him to. But Mudace is all over Daybreak right now. 109 in the thing, baby. 109 is not a thing.
And Daybreak is a Wolf main, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, the Roy may not be as proficient in this matchup as he is with Wolf, and right now Mudace is taking a crazy advantage over this matchup. It just seems like Daybreak, the onus is on him to approach. Mudace is more than happy to sit on the other side of the stage and let him come to him and then whiff punish.
Yeah, no, Daybreak has been doing that the whole match! The whole time as Peach, he has been spacing himself perfectly, giving himself the opportunity to force Daybreak to whiff and actually getting that stock. Good stuff by Mudace. But if you are Daybreak, what do you think needs to be changed?
See, the thing is that Daybreak was pushing forward just a little bit too much, right?
Mm-hmm.
If Daybreak takes his time, slows the game down, plays at his pace, he's letting Mudace kind of... Obviously, the whiff punishing is Mudace's playstyle, right? And so at some point, you do kind of have to... You have to approach Mudace in a way so that you're making it seem like you're about to get whiff punished, that you're falling for the trap. Then you back off yourself a little bit. And that's what Smash becomes, right? Smash being a platform game, it's all about the movement. It's all about making sure that you're baiting people out. And with people who play whiff punish styles in particular, you really have to make sure that you don't overcommit into them. Because that's all they're looking for, is that overcommitment. So if I'm Daybreak, I'm chilling. I'm going to laser camp a little bit. I'm going to run out over to the other side of the stage, use explosive flame, whatever I've got to do.
Yeah, no, I like that you say Laser Camp, because as a Wolfman myself, the funny thing is that whenever you lose a matchup and you ask what did I do wrong, whatever, you ask your friends, the first thing they say is, did you shoot the gun?
Yeah, did you shoot,
like,
hey, shoot the gun, huh, man, shoot the gun.
Maybe I should have shot the gun.
Yeah, the gun is your best tool as well. The thing is that Wolf's approach options are very linear. You're super susceptible to parrying. You're super susceptible to whiff punishing. And so you need to make your opponent come to you. And so as Wolf, you really need to shoot the gun, especially in this matchup.
So the lesson that we can take away here is shoot the gun.
Yes.
But we are going Rosa. Now, Rosa versus Roy, it can get pretty dicey. You know, she's not the same as she was in Smash 4. And Roy is so much of a better character at this point.
Yeah, that said, I mean, Rosa has some stuff, definitely, in this game. I really feel
sure,
like Rosa
man.
Is slept on. The issue is Luma just dies so easily.
Mm-hmm. And look,
everything puts Luma into it.
And look at him. He's not even fighting Rosa. Doing a great job of taking out Luma. And that's the first thing that you want to do, right? You have to know the matchup.
Yeah, and that's, you know, Daybreak is going to be targeting that star like it's got a red dot in its head.
And notice, he knows that he took away Mute Ace's jump, and he tries to capitalize on that. Jab to back air is a confirmed, and that is going to take it.
Yeah, especially on a floaty character like Rosa, that's kills super early and has a huge window for it as well.
Hey, right now we see Mute Ace carry his Peach style onto Palutena with that, you know, trying to make him whiff punish, really. Explosive Flame trying to bait out an option, not going to do it just yet.
Standing a little too close to the ledge there, looking for the down tilt. You can definitely space that farther away and still land it. The down tilt's huge, so many active frames. Definitely, you know, Palutena's best tool for getting that two frame. This is that's the exact spot you want to stand as Mute Ace.
Mm-hmm.
Back air, not enough. Mute Ace still got control, but Daybreak kind of fights his way back in, 142, and now he's just getting, like, that was just a missed opportunity for Mute Ace. You know, once you lose stage control like that, you're just kicking yourself, because, I mean, he took about 15-20% from that, just because of that interaction.
Yeet.
Hey, man, call him as you see.
Oh,
whoa,
no.
He was ready, but he didn't do anything.
He overstepped his bounds. And this is when things get hairy, because I don't think that Daybreak is very comfortable with Palu at this point. As we see, Mute Ace is just kind of watching him in the diddle, already caught up. God damn, that! Why did that hurt so much? You know when you hear something and it sounds like it just hurt.
That was a crunch. Yeah, the Palu diddle definitely going Mute Ace's way so far. It just doesn't seem like Daybreak has...
Oh!
No, he's not as good at finding the combo starters as Mute Ace is.
Yeah, and as Palutena, that's a problem. When you can't find those openings, when you can't tack on that pressure, that be... Oh, I like the reflect.
Ooh.
Okay, she's fine. Okay, she may be not fine.
Oh, the Nair a little bit misspaced. Okay. And now Mute Ace is in the corner, but Daybreak just gives him the stage.
And that's the thing with Daybreak. He has to put on a bit more pressure. He's not doing quite enough of instilling the fear in Mute Ace. You know, Mute Ace has gotten a lot with this Palu stock that he really shouldn't have been able to have. And I'd like, why did he die? That back air is strong, so I mean, he might have just been at the percent.
Possible. I think he just started dashing left or something like that.
Oh no. Oh no! Oh my god.
Dude. Only a Wolfmane screams there.
No, because in my head, I saw the win box. I'm like, oh, God, he's going Dance Smash. He's going to happen. It's going to happen.
All right, man. All right,
but, you know,
he's got such a good lead right now. And he's at high percent, yes, but, like,
and
one interaction. That's it. One interaction.
He knows that he doesn't need to overcommit right now, which is why he's just spacing out the back air. Great job. You know, look at that. Back air on his shield. It is safe. Running back, getting the dash attack.
Yeah, and Mute Ace is doing such a good job of not overcommitting into Daybreak right now.
You can't, dude.
No,
but you know what the thing is, though? What he's playing, like I pointed this out before.